Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find global extrema in a function of two variables. So we've got a function of the two variables x and y, and it's equal to 2x squared plus 3y squared minus 12x minus 6y plus 9. And we've been asked to find global extrema of this function if there are any. So what we need to do first is take the first order partial derivatives of the function f of xy. So we're going to take the partial derivative of f with respect to x, and we're going to take the partial derivative of f with respect to y. So I'm going to assume for the moment that you know roughly how to take partial derivatives and kind of move through it quickly. But basically, when we take the partial derivative of f with respect to x, remember that we're treating x as the variable and holding y constant, treating it like a constant as if it were a number, like 3 or 4. So we're only going to be looking at x as a variable. So the derivative of 2x squared with respect to x is 4x. The derivative of 3y squared will be 0 because there's no x variable involved in that term. The derivative of negative 12x will be negative 12. And the derivative of negative 6y plus 9, both of those terms will be 0 when taking the derivative because, again, there's no x variable involved in those terms. So the partial derivative of f with respect to x is 4x minus 12. The partial derivative of f with respect to y, in this case, we'll be treating y as the variable and holding x constant. The derivative of 2x squared will be 0 because there's no y variable involved. The derivative of 3y squared will be 6y. The derivative of negative 12x will be 0. The derivative of negative 6y will be negative 6, and the derivative of 9 will be 0 because, again, no y variable involved in that term. So once we've taken the first order partial derivatives of f, we need to set both of them equal to 0 and solve them each for their respective variable. So in this case, we're going to set 4x minus 12 equal to 0 and solve for x. So we'll do so by adding 12 to both sides, and we'll get 4x equals 12. Then we'll divide both sides by 4 to get x equals 3. And I'll come back to that in a second. Now we're going to set the partial derivative of f with respect to y equal to 0. We will add 6 to both sides to get 6y equals 6, and then divide both sides by 6 to get y equals 1. Notice that we have one answer for x and one answer for y. This tells us that those two things together make up the coordinates of our extrema point. So we've got x equals 3, y equals 1. That means we have an extrema point at 3, 1. We don't yet know if it's a global maximum or a global minimum or a saddle point, but we know that we have an extrema point at 3, 1. So now that we've determined what the point is, we need to determine the quality of the point, whether it's a max, a min, or a saddle point. And in order to do that, we need to take the second order partial derivatives of f, both the partial derivatives with respect to x and y, as well as the mixed second order partial derivative. So let's go ahead and do that. The second order partial derivative of f with respect to x is noted like this. And basically what we're going to do is look at the first order partial derivative of f with respect to x, and take it with respect to x again. So the derivative of 4x minus 12 with respect to x is simply 4. The second order partial derivative of f with respect to y, again, we'll be looking at the first order partial derivative with respect to y, and simply taking the derivative of our answer with respect to y again. So the derivative of 6y minus 6 with respect to y is just 6. And then we're looking for the mixed second order partial derivative, which looks like this. And in this case, instead of before, we took this one with respect to x, and then x again, y, and then y again. This time, we need to pick either one of these two. We can pick either one. And then we take the derivative with respect to the opposite variable. So we could either take the derivative of this one with respect to y, because we took the derivative with respect to x earlier, or take the derivative of this one with respect to x, since we took the derivative with respect to y earlier. So let's go ahead and pick The first one, we'll take the derivative of 4x minus 12, but this time with respect to y. Well, taking the derivative of that with respect to y is just going to give us 0, because remember, when we're taking the derivative with respect to y, we are treating y as the variable and x as a constant. Well, that means that both 4x and 12 are going to be constants. The derivative constants are 0, so this mixed second-order partial derivative is going to be 0. So now that we've found the three second-order partial derivatives, we can use this information to determine whether our extrema point 3, 1 is a max, a min, or a saddle point. So in order to do that, we're going to use this formula here, d of xy. And I've seen the formula written a bunch of different ways, but basically the important thing to remember is that you're going to multiply the second order partial derivative with respect to x by the second order partial derivative with respect to y, and then subtract the mixed second order partial derivative squared. This squared exponent here is important to remember. So basically for us, that means that d of xy is going to be equal to the second order partial derivative with respect to x, which we know to be 4. So we've got 4 times the second order partial derivative with respect to y, which is 6, minus the mixed second order partial derivative, which is 0, squared. Remember this squared exponent here. Don't forget that. So 4 times 6 minus 0 squared, which in our case obviously is equal to 24. So basically, you take the first order partial derivative, set them equal to 0, solve for the extrema point. Once you've got it, take the second order partial derivatives, all three of them, then you plug your values into this d of xy equation. So now you've got a value for d of xy, and you can use this, you can use d of xy, and you can use the second order partial derivative with respect to x, those two pieces of information together to determine whether it's a max, a min, or a saddle point. So what you care about is whether or not those two values are less than or equal to 0. So look at d first, always. You're going to look at d first and determine whether or not it is greater than or less than 0. Since it's greater than 0, that means that we have to look at the second order partial derivative with respect to x, and I'll go through the other possibilities in a second. Now we're going to look at the second order partial derivative with respect to x. It is also greater than 0. So when both of them are greater than 0, that means that our extrema point, 3, 1, is going to be a global minimum. Global minimum. When d is greater than 0, but the partial second order partial derivative of f with respect to x is less than 0, you're looking at a global max. And when d of xy is less than 0, you're looking at a saddle point, and it doesn't matter what the value of the second order partial derivative of f with respect to x actually is. So in this case, both are greater than 0, which means that the extrema point 3, 1 is going to be a global minimum. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!